The game of Survivor in its early years was really beginning to build its strategic roots, but the winner of the Cook Islands took that to a whole new level. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffed, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be revisiting Survivor Cook Islands as we take a look back at Kwon's journey to the title of Sole Survivor. Survivor Cook Islands was divided into four tribes by ethnicity, and we were first introduced to Kwon, a 31-year-old management consultant from San Mateo, California, as a member of the Asian American Puka Puka tribe alongside Becky Lee, an attorney from Washington, D.C., 29-year-old Brad Verrata, and Cowboy Bu, a 42-year-old nail salon manager. The division of tribes bar race was a controversial one and something that almost forced Yul to quit, not wanting to play into traditional stereotypes of Asian Americans, but he stuck strong, wanting to change representation.
I honestly was stunned. I mean, this is crazy. I mean, on one hand, I think it's a great opportunity because I think it's wonderful that there's more minorities. At the same time, I'm a little bit worried that it might play out to caricatures and stereotypes. So, I don't know, it'll be interesting to see how things play out.
At the marooning, Yul's chicken flew out of his hands and was stolen by Jonathan Penner, which resulted in Penner being sent to Exile Island by Puka Puka after winning the first challenge. Yul and Becky began to bond on Puka Puka Beach, while Cowboy was rubbing the tribe the wrong way with his Asian jokes and being stereotypical, something that Yul in particular was offended by. Yul was sent to Exile Island on day 5 and immediately found the hidden immunity idol, giving him power in the game, particularly when the tribe swap came 2 days later, and he found himself on the Aitutaki tribe alongside fellow tribe mates Becky and Cowboy. The former Puka Puka had the power on the new tribe and brought in Raro members Candace and Penner to their alliance, which would give them a 5-4 majority. Aitu lost immunity and Rarotonga sent Candace to exile to keep her safe, which ruined Aitu's plans, so instead they brought in Cowboy and Flicker to eliminate Cecilia and maintain strengthening numbers. As part of a double elimination twist, Cowboy began to scheme and presented Plan Voodoo, suggesting that the former Puka Puka should split the votes between Jonathan and Candace to break up the perceived White's alliance and flush the idol, as they were the only other people to have visited Exile Island.
I think the plan is ingenious. I know that neither Jonathan or Candace have the hidden immunity idol, because I have it. But it's a great plan to break down Jonathan's alliance with the members of the original White tribe.
Although Yul knew that this was a dangerous plan, as it would reveal that he in fact had the idol, so he plotted to eliminate Cowboy, with Flicker following after him. On day 20, the game was flipped on its head when the remaining 12 castaways were given the opportunity to mutiny, and both Candace and Penner opted to join Rarotonga, leaving Aitutaki with only 4 remaining members and Aussie firmly at the bottom. But the Aitu-4 were strong, winning all their remaining challenges and making Candace pay for her betrayal by sending her to Exile Island at every single opportunity. Yul entered the merge with his numbers down 5-4 to Rarotonga, but he managed to use his hidden immunity idol as leverage to help flip Penner back to Aitu in order to eliminate Nate. This move was the first time we had seen the idol used as a way to gain trust and completely shifted the game, pushing it back in Yul's favour, as not only did it give Aitu the numbers once again, but it also damaged Penner's standing in the game and caused fractures within the former Raro tribe.
Our backs are against the wall. We need someone to flip. We've kind of come up with a desperate plan based on the fact that I had the hidden immunity idol, and it could change, hopefully, the whole flow of the game.
Jonathan, I know, is more than anything else, he's a rational player.
Yeah, and no, I agree.
Like, he's gonna put above, like, personal considerations.
No, I
don't know if the other people here would do that.
I agree.
Jonathan, if I can convince him,
he's the one person having his best luck.
Yeah, in a rational sense. Yeah. You know what? You come over, we have the numbers, I have the idol. Can't beat us.
It sounds like it might be the best plan to do that.
All right, I'm gonna go look for it.
At the auction, after Becky sent Candace to Exile Island, Yul ended the suspense, knowing that his position in the final four was assured given the strength of the Aitu alliance, and revealed he was in possession of the hidden immunity idol and had found it at the first opportunity.
Looks authentic.
Candace paid the price for her betrayal, being eliminated, and Yul recognised that he was viewed as the brains behind the operation, so not wanting to be criticised for his ruthless gameplay, he decided to appease Adam by agreeing to vote out Penner first. In the aftermath of Penner's blindside, Yul played to the jury by bringing Penner's hat back to Tribal Council before going on to eliminate Parvati, with Adam becoming the final member of Rarotonga to have his torch snuffed. It was revealed that this season would be the first to have a final three, so after Aussie won final individual immunity, Yule knew his place at Final Tribal Council was guaranteed given that he was in possession of the Hidden Immunity Idol. He offered the idol to Becky, but she rejected it, wanting to fight her way to the end and not be perceived as riding Yule's coattails the whole game. With Yule and Ozzy's place guaranteed, Becky and Sundra fought it out for the final spot at Final Tribal Council in a fiery battle for the ages. And ages. And ages.
The fact that I was able to start this whole adventure with Becky on day one, the fact that I'm able to finish it with her, you know, it's gotta be a dream, right?
Oh, congratulations, guys!
Finding a really good friend is worth more than $1 million. I mean, friendships like the one that I have with Becky, I think, are that rare.
Starfruit?
I tried to play the game with as much integrity as I could. I know that I failed in a lot of respects, but, you know, hopefully people won't hold it against me that I beat them.
At the Final Tribal Council, Yule sat along Becky and Ozzy and explained his strategy from forging a bond with Becky early in the game, to bringing in Candace and Penna at the tribe swap, and finally using his idol as leverage to flip Penna at the merge. Yule also went on to say how much it meant to him that he was given the opportunity to represent Asian Americans on television and do so in a positive manner. Candace was a swing vote in the end, but he was respected for both his strategic and social game, winning in a 5-4-0 vote over Ozzy Lust and Becky Lee to be crowned the sole survivor.
The winner of Survivor Cook Islands.
Yule Kwon played an extremely savvy game. He used his social abilities to create an unbreakable alliance with Becky that would last 39 days, and also used game theory to ensure that every possible move that was made in the game ultimately benefited him. Yule changed the way idols were used in Survivor, making him seem unstoppable as he fought his way through the game. What did you think of Yule Kwon's journey to the title Soul Survivor? Let us know in the comment section down below. If you enjoy this content, please feel free to give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. Stay tuned next time as we delve into the story of Earl Cole, winner of Survivor Fiji. The game of Survivor requires more than just strength and social skills. It takes analytical thought and extremely savvy gameplay to dominate. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
So like I was saying, I'm playing the game. That's what I came here to do. My prize isn't even $1 million. My prize was that I fell in love in this game. Love at first sight. Her name is
Yule.
And in between,
Yule.
From Puka.
Yeah. After the last challenge, we sort of mouthed the words I love you to one another. And so that was my prize. And my prize was
Yule.